Hey everybody, Austin back again with another Let's Play video. Today it's going to be Sonic the Hedgehog for the Sega Genesis. This is a game I've been wanting to Let's Play for quite some time now, several years actually, and I just never got around to it. So we're going to go ahead and throw down with some Sonic the Hedgehog, the good old Sega Genesis classic. I actually played this earlier this week, this week, and I ran through the game in one sitting. And got all the Chaos Emeralds and got the good ending. And we'll see if we can do that now. I might not be able to. Sometimes getting the Chaos Emeralds is a little difficult. Depends on your performance in the bonus stages, as well as if you get 50 rings by the exit of each of your first two acts on each world. So we'll see what we can do. So let's get right into it. So we're actually playing this on a Sega Genesis with an actual Sega Genesis controller. And so that means no spin dash or anything like that. The reason I mention that is in later versions of the game, starting with Sonic Jam on the Sega Saturn, they gave you the option to play with the spin dash. They programmed it back into the game. Well, not really back into the game, but into the game. Because the spin dash never existed in the first Sonic the Hedgehog. It was something that came into being with Sonic the Hedgehog 2 and Sonic CD for the Sega CD. So yeah, good old classic Sonic the Hedgehog. I'll be honest with you guys, after beating it the other day, I wasn't that satisfied with the game. I don't think the first Sonic the Hedgehog has aged quite as gracefully as Sonic's 2 and 3. And I don't want to be too negative in this Let's Play. The first few levels in this game I think are still amazing, like Green Hill Zone and the Marble Zone. They're really solid. But after that, there's a ton of stop-and-go gameplay. And that last level, Scrap Brain, man, that level can go screw itself. It's traps everywhere. But we'll see what happens. Maybe I'll just eat my own words as I go through this game. I'll be like, oh, these levels are actually awesome. You know, when I ran through it earlier this week, it was actually the first time I had beaten this game in probably a good 4 or 5 years or something like that. So that's one Chaos Emerald down. You need to get 6. 5 plus 1. You need to get 6 for the good ending. So again, we'll see if that's something we can do. I'm going to go ahead and take the bottom route down here. A bunch of rings and a shield. So what's going to end up happening, guys, is I'll probably end up rolling through Sonics 2 and 3 after this. When after this, I'm not sure. But it is something that's definitely going to happen sometime in the future. And then I'd like to also Let's Play Sonic CD, which I've actually done a few videos on that game in the past, and I've also done a stream on it, but I haven't actually done a straight Let's Play or long play video, so that is definitely going to happen in the future. Again, it's just the sort of thing that's when it's going to happen, I do not know. So, but we'll see. Maybe I'll go on a Sonic the Hedgehog kick, kind of like I did with my Mega Man Let's Play series, where I pretty much did all 6 Mega Mans in like a week-long time span. Alright, so pretty much from here on these bonus stages, you kind of want to take your time. And that's, well, kind of why you take your time. I totally screwed up there. I didn't think that was going to exit me out. So, that's no good. So that means it's probably going to be a little bit harder to get all the Chaos Emeralds now, since I pretty much messed that up. The reason I say that is that you're not able to get a Chaos Emerald on Act 3 of each world. And the farther you get into the game, the harder it is, I think, to get to the end of the level with 50 rings or more. Which is pretty much... actually, let's see if we get this extra life up here. Got it. So yeah, on the third act, that's the boss act. So you're not allowed to try to get a Chaos Emerald on the third stage of each world, which is what we're on right now. So if you do it just right, you can have all six Chaos Emeralds by the end of World 3. After that, it gets a little bit more difficult. Again, the level design gets a little bit trickier. Well, I should say a lot trickier. And so I kind of messed up there, but we'll see what happens. Good old Sonic the Hedgehog. There's, you know, I'm actually like at a loss for words as I'm playing this game. Normally, in this part of the Let's Play, I'm just constantly talking, just talking, 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 right? It's like I can't shut up. But I'm playing this game and I'm like, what do I say? It's Sonic the Hedgehog, and I'm pretty sure pretty much every one of you guys out there have played this game. If you haven't, you really should give this a try. The Sonic the Hedgehog series in recent years is kind of... I'd say the series has been tainted. But these classic Sonic the Hedgehog games are excellent, excellent games. And there's a very good reason why they were extremely popular back in the day. They hold up very, very well from a gameplay perspective. From a graphical perspective, they are excellent on the Sega Genesis. Some of the best looking games on the Genesis, I think. Sonic the Hedgehog 1, again, hasn't aged as gracefully as parts 2 and 3, which makes sense. It was a game from 1991. But, I mean, even Sonic 1 still looks really awesome at parts. Especially the first level, or the first world, Green Hill Zone. And just sort of taking my time here, because I don't want to lose my rings if I can avoid it. But yeah, I definitely recommend playing this game. Start with the first one, go from there, go to Sonic 2, go to Sonic 3. Sonic and Knuckles, you can play it, it's good, it's really good, but you really need to lock that on the Sonic 3 to get the proper experience. And, but yeah, these early Sonic games are just fantastic games. Even with, some complaints I have on this game in terms of later level design, it is still a really good game, and definitely, you know, has held up well over the years. Again, as gracefully as the others, nah, maybe not. I mean, Sonic 2 is just really an incredible game. One thing I do like about Sonic 1, though, that wasn't in Sonic 2 or 3, is that when you get to the end sign, if you jump in certain areas, you'll get those little hidden point icons, and you can get upwards of 10,000 points per one. And, whoa. So I always thought that was kind of fun. And I want to say this emerald is just, like, dead center. Yeah. Oh, jeez. Phew, got it. Okay, so apparently, if you fail at a bonus stage, the next time you get to one, it's going to go to the next bonus stage in order. Which is interesting, because that bonus stage, I think, was actually easier than the last one I was at. Sonic 2 actually acts differently on its bonus stages. If you fail at a bonus stage, and then you get back to the bonus stage later on, you have to play through the same one again. So in Sonic 2, you have to go through all 6 or 7 bonus stages in order. And if you get stuck at one, well, tough luck. You've gotta get better at it, I guess. Whoa, that was close. So it's interesting that Sonic 1 does it that way, or, you know, where it it'll still advance to the bonus stage, even though you failed at the one prior, which is interesting. That's not good. Not good at all. It's okay, I didn't lose my rings. Because again, you need 50 rings to get to the bonus stage, and I want to get the good ending on this playthrough if I can. You know, I'm not going to cry if I don't get the good ending, because I wanted to just play through the game anyway, but my goal is to get the good ending. That's always my goal when I play Sonic the Hedgehog, the original Sonic the Hedgehog games. Now, I think there's actually a secret over there in the bottom, but I'm not going to worry about it. Because when you go to it, you have to go all the way back across the lava, and then all the way back across the lava again. Yeah, see, there's a room down here with a bunch of boxes, and I don't really care. As long as I can get my 10 rings, which I need, I'll be happy. Come on. There we go. There's my 10 rings. So now I have to make sure I don't lose my shield. And we're at a point already where you sort of have to start taking your time. And one of the only issues I have with the first Sonic the Hedgehog is that you really, really have to start slowing down your game. Oops, lost my shield. Starting with the third world. The third zone, I should say. You really have to start slowing down your game. If you want to get your 50 rings and survive and get to the bonus stage. Another shield. And by the end of the game, it's like, you can't even run through the level at all. You pretty much have to, you pretty much have to just really tiptoe your way through the game, which is kind of counterproductive for a game called Sonic the Hedgehog. You know, which is a name indicative of going really fast. And, ironically, you actually do the exact opposite on the later stages. You just go really, really damn slow. And Sonic the Hedgehog 2 and 3 actually address that a bit. They all have their stop-and-go moments, but they definitely have more fast-paced moments, even later on in the games. But it makes sense that the first Sonic the Hedgehog wasn't quite as refined. I mean, it was the first game in the series. So, you got a bunch of these, like, balls on the walls. You can see the one up there that says down, and if I touch that, the rotation speed of the map will slow down. And likewise, if I hit the one that says up, it'll speed up. So, ideally, you want things to be kind of slow if you, you know, don't want to have trouble here. And it looks like you can sort of follow the rings. Oh, crap, man. I did it again. Jesus Christ. All you have to do is just follow the rings, and that sort of takes you where you need to go. And that puts me in a really bad spot. Like, you really need to get your Chaos Emeralds early on in the game, otherwise it gets tough to collect them. So that's bad. Very, very bad, guys. And for the one or two out there that maybe have never played a Sonic the Hedgehog game before, the big gimmick in this game is that you're pretty much invincible until you have zero rings on you. Or if you hit a pit, an endless pit. Or in Sonic the Hedgehog 1, two spikes in a row without touching the ground. That'll also kill you in one hit. So, pretty much the first thing you want to do when you get hit in this game, like this, is grab a ring. Oops, missed it. All it takes is one. As long as you have one ring, you will survive. So, I mean, if I really wanted to, I could just, like, skip through everything like this. And get a little reckless with things. Ooh. And then your floating platform disappears. So, bad example on that part. Oops. One thing that I think definitely worked better in Sonic the Hedgehog 2 is that they allowed you to go to the bonus stages at, like, checkpoints. Whereas in this one, you can't, and so if you're trying to get all the Chaos Emeralds, it's just like, it really stings when you fail at at the bonus world. Alright, so we're on to Zone 3. Springyard Zone, Act 1. Oh, I missed it. Missed it again. Go me. And again, this is where the game really becomes stop and go. I mean, we had hints of that on the marble zone, but here it's just, you gotta go through all these vertical segments just like this, nice and slow. I'm not a fan of these, those dudes that just roll in. It almost looks like they're like a precursor to the Metal Sonic. And again, this is where you gotta be stop and go already. I hate this level design. I mean, it's my fault. It's totally my fault for not, you know, paying attention, just slamming into these things. Sonic 2 and 3 really put you into the mindset where you just really want to go fast all the time, and that doesn't really work so well in this game. If you try to go really fast on these later stages, you get punished, basically. So, I'm only coming back here, this is kind of going backwards, but I'm coming back here to get some rings, because I lost quite a bit of rings going that bottom path. And I'm not as familiar with these stages as I used to be. Like, I used to know all these levels inside and out back when I was a kid. But now that I barely play this game anymore, every time I play the game, it's like I have to relearn some of the levels. There's not a problem with that. So I'm gonna take it easy here. Oh, freaking seriously, man. Alright, screw it. I'm dying. I don't think there's gonna be 50 rings here. I've got enough lives. I can sacrifice a few lives. That really sucks. Ah, damn enemies. Yeah, I had a feeling that was the exit, so that's why I was trying to take it extra careful. So we're back in another bonus stage. Ah, freaking chaos emeralds and freaking enemies and freaking Sonic the Hedgehog. Super fast! Trying to figure out which way I need to go. I want to say going down this way is bad. Got it. You gotta be really patient on these bonus stages. Sonic the Hedgehog 3 is a little similar in how you have to be patient on the bonus levels, but they're a little more straightforward. It's a little bit easier in Sonic 3 to not lose. Sonic 1, with that rotating map and everything like that, it's very easy to mess up. Thank you. Actually, I really should be going the top way. I'm not gonna... The bottom way, you get those little rolling dudes that come from behind you, then you've got the big spikes in the tunnels and stuff like that, so... I'm really better off just going the top way if it allows me to. There they are. I really don't know these levels that well anymore. I mean, in terms of, like, you know, I got the general layout, like, never mind, I don't even know where I'm going with that. I just don't know exactly when the levels are ending, like I used to. I don't know when to be able to run fast, and when I have to run slow, and... Got it. What are we up to now? Is that four? Only four. I still need two more. It's all good. We're on Act 3. And so after this, we'll be going to the Labyrinth Zone. Which is probably the infamous water level. I say infamous because I don't really know if anybody actually likes the water levels in this game. And there's two of them, actually. There's the Labyrinth Zone, which consists of three acts. And then on the Scrap Brain Zone, you get tossed back into another labyrinth-style level for one act. Oh, geez. This is why you don't just run ahead. You have to take your time, and it just bugs the hell out of me. Like, I hate taking my time in a Sonic game. Like, here and there is fine, but just... It's like every time I just start running, I slam into something. Why am I even taking my time? It doesn't even matter. This is Act 3. I can just slam into whatever I want. I can just keep getting hit, you know, it's like... I'm so in the Chaos Emerald mindset that I'm even taking Act 3 slow, which I shouldn't. Although this part right here, you do have to take slow, because I believe it's an endless pit below me right now. So you have to be a little bit more careful here. And the boss fight actually has an endless pit scenario as well. But he's actually not a hard boss. Oops. Whoa. The bosses in this game really are not difficult at all, but, you know, if you get a little reckless, you will get punished. Alright, so Labyrinth Zone. Now we need to get 50 rings to get back to the bonus level. You got these air bubbles here, and you need to make sure you get those as often as you can. Otherwise, Sonic can drown. If you want to avoid drowning, just take these levels pretty slow. And if you see an air bubble, just wait. Just wait for the air bubble to come up, like now. Grab it, and then move on. If you play somewhat methodical like that, you shouldn't have too much trouble in this level. It's just that on this level, you do have quite a few different, some dangers in the map itself. You've got rising platforms, you've got spikes everywhere, you've got, these spiked ball and chain things that are rotating around. You've also got these heads that'll start shooting out fireballs underwater. Yeah, I don't know, it doesn't really make a whole lot of sense, but yeah, it's a threat, you gotta watch out for it. And I'm not sure if we'll actually see that on Act 1, but we'll definitely see it on Act 2, I believe. So even though I've got 50 rings, I have a tendency to still try to grab all the rings that I can, because if you can get 100 rings, you get an extra life. Not that I really need any more extra lives, but it's always a nice feeling grabbing that extra life from getting all those rings. Two, if you're playing for score, which I don't know if anybody really does that in a Sonic the Hedgehog game, but I still try to get the biggest score I can, just for fun. And all your rings are calculated at the end of each stage, and they definitely add up over the course of the game. Alright, next bonus stage. So anybody out there watching, if you're still watching, have you played any Sonic the Hedgehog games before? I assume you have, but I'm curious to know your thoughts on the series, particularly these old ones. I don't really, you don't need to really talk about the new ones, but if you've played any of these old Sonic the Hedgehogs, let me know what you think of the series. What is your favorite classic Sonic the Hedgehog game? Do you still thoroughly enjoy Part 1? Do you prefer part 2? How do you like part 3 and Knuckles? What I'm curious to know is if any of you guys out there had played games like Sonic CD and Knuckles Chaotix. Knuckles Chaotix being a 32X game. I really like Knuckles Chaotix. It's slower paced, but it's just a fun game. Doesn't have too many devious traps. You just kind of mosey along throughout the levels and soak in the nice graphics, because it is a good-looking game. Taking our time. It's just, and when you hear the music reset like that, like it just did, that means the panic countdown timer was about to come on. And it gets really annoying, actually. So, yeah, when the music resets after you get a bubble, you know, like, the countdown timer was literally just about to turn on. And when the countdown timer does turn on, you've got 5 seconds to get some air. Either get above water or get an air bubble. Or Sonic dies. That's weird. Look at that. I'm not spinning. Interesting. I'm taking advantage of this invincibility. I can't talk right now. Alright, get an air bubble. Got an air bubble. Let's get another air bubble. Got it. Got another extra life for that 100 rings. Let's get another air bubble. I know, exciting stuff, isn't it, guys? See if we can get this last Chaos Emerald, and then I can just sort of like skip through the rest of the game and be a little more reckless. That's the thing about going for the Chaos Emeralds, is you have to be careful. Otherwise you risk not getting the Chaos Emeralds. Oh, jeez, I was... These things get intense, because you can just... You can fail just like that. Alright, is that it? That's all six, right? I'm pretty sure that's all six. Yeah, Sonic got them all. Thanks, game, for letting me know. So, unlike Sonic 2 or 3, no Supersonic in this game or anything like that. Which is a bit of a shame, but, eh. Actually, Supersonic in this game would be awesome for that final stage. You could totally get reckless on that final level, and that would be awesome. I wonder if someone's made a hack where they like hacked in Supersonic to the first Sonic the Hedgehog. I don't even know if that would be possible without like fully reprogramming certain aspects of the game, but that would be pretty sweet, I think. Supersonic in Sonics 2 and 3 is really what makes going for the Chaos Emeralds worth it. I mean, aside from the better ending, it's really all about getting Supersonic in those games. That way you can really just blaze through the rest of the game. So there's an extra layer of satisfaction from getting your Chaos Emeralds in Sonics 2 and 3. Come on. Whereas in this, you mostly just do it for the good ending. And that's about it. And to be able to say you've done it. It's not really that difficult, it's just... You know, again, you gotta be patient as you're playing the game. And, it could definitely put you on edge a little bit. Some of those bonus stages, man, like I said, they can just end... Like, in the blink of an eye, basically. Oh, seriously, dude? Not cool, man. At least the game knows better. We might even be getting close to Robotnik now. Robotnik on this, you don't actually attack him, you just go vertically. I mean, if you touch him, fine, but it's not really necessary. You just need to get to the top. While watching out for all these traps. And the water comes up behind you, too. And that's it. Starlight Zone. Alright, so last time I played this level, I ended up taking the bottom path. And what I'm gonna try to do is take the top portion of the level if I can. If it's even an option. Extra life, gonna skip it. Yeah, last time I played it, I went downwards. And I want to say, taking the top path, you can go a little bit faster. I think the game lets you go a little bit faster. Really? Is that it? Uh-oh. Oops. Thought it was gonna go down the other way. Thank you. Seriously. This is the Sonic the Hedgehog, I remember. Loops, fast running. That's what it's all about. And 10,000 point icons. Life is so good when you're not worrying about Chaos Emeralds. Oh, scheisse. Should probably stop saying that. I was saying that word a lot when I was let's playing Wolfenstein 3D on the Jaguar last week. Or streaming the game, not let's playing it. I mean, it was let's playing, but it was a Twitch stream. Whoa. That's it. On to Act 3 already. So this has been the fastest zone so far, since we haven't had to worry about the Chaos Emeralds. If you didn't get your Chaos Emeralds by this point, good luck getting them. That's why you want to get them done early on in the game, if you can. This is where the Spin Dash would be useful. Really? Come on. No. Stop it, fan. Come on. Alright, whatever. We're going the bottom way. Waiting for these dudes to explode. Because they're dangerous. Lots of springs that don't put me anywhere. Okay. Regurgitating existing level design, I see. Whoa! Only they disappear. That's different. Okay. Probably a secret down there, but I'm just gonna skip it. Alright, boss time. Look at that. Fastest zone yet, guys. Alright, we're at the final zone now, Scrap Brain. Which is definitely the most pain in the ass zone in the game. You'll see why once we get to it. Ugh. Pretty much everything below me is an endless pit right now, so you have to be very, very careful on this level. Ooh, that was close. Ooh, very close. Very, very close. Whew. I got lucky there. Oh, come on, man. Seriously? It's like they just come out of nowhere. Not a fan of enemies that can shoot when they're not even on screen yet. It's just kind of unfair. You just start running, it's like, bam! There is a projectile! Out of nowhere. Maybe if, like, the projectiles made a sound bouncing down the hill, it would be different, but I don't think they do. Come on! The physics are so weird in this game. Yay! Alright, so at the end of this level, we're gonna get knocked down to another labyrinth-style stage. And then that's gonna be Act 3. Oops. And then once we come back up, we pretty much fight the final boss. Which is Robotnik, of course. Or Eggman, as they call him today. I have to say, Robotnik really wants you dead in the first Sonic the Hedgehog. In Sonic 2 and 3, you know, he's a little more tame. He's got, like, these really big final stages, but he doesn't have as many, like, these traps. He's got some, but, I mean, this is just, like, razor blades coming at you from behind and stuff like that. Alright, Now the actual final stage. Where are my bubbles at? Come on. There we go. Alright, I think we're getting close to the end already. I remember this part, I think. These labyrinth-style level designs can get a little confusing just because they all... Every part kind of looks the same. And so it really requires, like, repeated playthroughs. Yeah, we're pretty much towards the end already. I remember that part. I died there a lot the last time I played this. Like, you'd get there waiting for the bubble to appear, and it wouldn't, so you're actually better off just jumping up and getting some actual air. And look at that, you have no rings for some odd reason. So this is a pretty basic pattern. I usually just try to, you know, sit here to the right, wait for Robotnik to come out on one of the right two holes, and then just... Like, I got lucky there. Three times in a row, he was on the right. So, just wait here. And if there's a spin dash, you'd be able to actually attack him if he was on the left. Right at the last second. Unfortunately, no spin dash in this game. When I had Sonic Jam on the Sega Saturn, I had actually thought about doing a Let's Play of that version with the spin dash enabled. I think it would definitely make the game a little more interesting. Wow, getting really lucky with these. Because sometimes he would just, like, appear... Man, look at that! Sometimes he'll appear all the way at the left, and if you're all the way at the right, you just won't be able to hit him. But... But this is kind of like, this is how I like to do it. It just, it seems the safest to me. And that's it. I can put the controller down. So there you go, guys. That's the good ending. Very, very short good ending. I don't know if any of this is actually in the regular ending. It probably is. I don't remember, though. If you guys know what the difference is between the normal ending and the good ending, let me know. Post in the comments below. I know that the big difference is that Sonic throws the Chaos Emeralds up. All the flowers grow big, and he jumps out at the screen, I believe. I think that's just good ending only. And that way, right here, with Sonic, like, floating through the tubes and grabbing onto the posts, that was brought back in Sonic the Hedgehog 3, which is pretty cool. I don't think it was in Sonic the Hedgehog 2, now that I think about it. And Robotnik is stomping the end sign. Right on. Alright, guys. Well, I guess that's basically it. That is Sonic the Hedgehog for the Sega Genesis. I hope you guys enjoyed this Let's Play. If you're new to my channel, feel free to subscribe. And to anybody else already watching my channel, feel free to follow me over at Twitch. I play a lot of these games. I've already done a few Sonic the Hedgehog games on Twitch live. It just a lot of times takes me longer to get around to doing them on YouTube. Because I actually have to sit down and spend time doing it. Then there's post-processing and all that stuff. So, but yeah, follow me over there. And, yeah, I don't know what else to say, guys. Sonic the Hedgehog, Let's Play. Hope you guys enjoyed it. I'll see you soon.